So, dear students, this is again a steam nozzle problem part 2. So, here we will see another 4 or 5 problems on the steam nozzle. Problem example 4.5, in a steam nozzle, dry and saturated steam is expanded from 11 bar to 0.1 bar. Using steam table, calculate dryness fraction of the steam at exit, velocity of this steam at nozzle exit if the initial velocity is 135 meters per second. The given data, initial condition of the steam 11 bar and dry saturated, final pressure is 0.1 bar and initial velocity is 135 meters per second. So from the steam table, you take table number 2. At 11 bar pressure for dry saturated steam, H1 equal to HG1 equal to 2779.7 kilojoules per kilogram, S1 equal to SG1 equal to 6.55 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now, at pressure P2 equal to 0.1 bar, you take HF2, HFG2, SF2 and SFG2, you note down from the steam table value. And the dryness fraction of the steam at exit for isentropic expansion, as we know, S1 equal to S2. Entropy is constant for isentropic expansion. So, S1 equal to S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. Substituting S1 equal to 6.55, SF2 equal to 0.649, SFG2 equal to 7.502, calculating X2 equal to 0.79. Then, enthalpy of the steam at exit, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, so which is 191.8 plus 0.79 into 2392.9 equal to 2082.2 kilojoules per kilogram. Then velocity at the exit, so here V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2 plus V1 square. In the earlier problem, velocity at the inlet was not given, and now velocity at the inlet is given, you have to use this equation. So, V2 equal to square root of 2 into 1000. The 1000 for converting kilojoules into joules into 2779.7 minus 2082.2 plus 135 square equal to 1188.8 meters per second. So, the answer, dryness fraction of the steam at exit X2 equal to 0.79 and velocity of the steam at exit equal to 1188.78 meters per second. And the next problem, example 4.6, the inlet condition of steam to a convergent divergent nozzle is 22 bar and 260 degrees Celsius. The exit pressure is 4 bar. The mass flow rate is 11 kilograms per second. Assume the expansion is isentropic and inlet velocity is negligible. Determine the throat area, exit velocity and exit area. Take n equal to 1.3 for superheated steam. Now, the given data, inlet condition P1 equal to 22 bar and T1 equal to 260 degrees Celsius, exit condition P3 equal to 4 bar, mass flow rate of the steam equal to 11 kilograms per second, the index of expansion is 1.3. So, the pressure at the throat of the nozzle that you have to calculate. So, the pressure at the throat of the nozzle, P2 by P1 equal to 2 by n plus 1 to the power n by n minus 1, or n equal to 1.3. So, substituting 1.3, this is 0.545. So, P2 equal to 0.545 into 22 equal to 12 bar. Now, from this steam table, superheated steam table, 22 bar 260 degrees Celsius. Saturation temperature is 217.2 degrees Celsius. Now, 260 degrees Celsius is not directly available. In the steam table, 250 is available, 300 is available. You note down H1 and S1 value for 250 and 300 and interpolate. Linear interpolation. Using the linear interpolation, we calculate the value for 260 degrees Celsius. So, for 260 degrees Celsius, H1 equal to 2918.58 kilojoules per kilogram, S1 equal to 6.534 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from table number 12 bar, at 12 bar, VG, HF, HFG, SF and SG. Similarly, 4 bar, VG, HF, HFG, SF and SFG. Now for the throat section, calculation of the throat section, we take S1 equal to S2 equal to SF2 plus X1 SFG2, substituting, and it comes X2 equal to 1. That means dry saturated steam. For dry saturated steam, H2 equal to HF2 plus HFG2, which is 2782.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And V2 equal to VG2, which is 0.16321 meter cube per kilogram. So, the velocity of the steam at the throat section, V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2 into 10 power 3. So, 2000 into 2918.58 minus 2782.7 equal to 521.3 meters per second. And at the throat section area equal to A2 equal to M into small v to specific volume divided by velocity, it equal to 11 into 0.16321 divided by 521.3. That is equal to 3.44 in 10 power minus 3 meter square. At the exit section, drainage fraction of the steam at the exit section, S1 equal to S3, which is equal to SF3 plus X3 into SFG3. Substituting S1 and SF3 and SFG3, X2 equal to 0.93. Now, for the enthalpy at the steam, enthalpy of the steam at the exit, H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3, substituting 604.7 plus 0.93 into 2132.9 equal to 2588.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the specific volume of the steam at the exit equal to X3 into VG3 for wet steam, 0.93 into 0.4622, that is equal to 0.4298 meter cube per kilogram. Now, the velocity of the steam at the exit, V3 equal to 2000 square root of 2000 into H1 minus H3, that is equal to 2000 into 2918.58 minus 2588.3, that is equal to 812.75 meters per second. And the area at the exit, A3 equal to M into specific volume V3 divided by velocity V3, 11 into 0.24298 divided by 812.75 equal to 5.82 10 power minus 3 meter square. So, the answers are throat area equal to 34.4 centimeter square, exit velocity is 812.75 meters per second, and exit area equal to 58.2 centimeter square. Now, the next problem 4.7, example 4.7, inlet condition to a steam nozzle are 10 bar and 250 degrees Celsius. The exit pressure is 2 bar and the mass flow rate of the steam is 0.2 kilograms per second. Assuming isentropic expansion equilibrium velocity, determine throat area, exit velocity and the exit area of the nozzle. So, this is initially 10 bar and 250 degrees Celsius. Exit condition P3 equal to 2 bar. Now, the solution from the P1, P1 equal to 10 bar and P1 equal to 10 bar and temperature is 2 degrees Celsius. From the superheated table, table number 4, enthalpy 2493 kilojoules per kilogram. Table number 5, entropy S1 equal to 6.926 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this table number 3, specific volume is 0.2328 meter cube per kilogram. So, steam is superheated. Initially, so steam is superheated at inlet. So, N equal to 1.3. Throat pressure equal to P1 into 2 by N plus 1 to the power N by N minus 1, which is equal to 10 into 2 by 1.3 plus 1 equal to 5.46 bar. Now, once again, referring to the steam table, we have values for 5.4 and 5.6. So, there is no 5.46. Now, we take the value 5.46, interpolate, we calculate the value. So, S1 equal to S2 equal to SG2 plus Cp into logarithmic of T2 by TS2. So, we assume the temperature, the steam quality at the throat section is superheated steam. So, I take the entropy equation for the superheated steam. So, calculating, substituting SG2, S1, SG2, 2. Cp you take 2.1 or 2.2 logarithmic of T2 by value. So, 155.2 plus 273. So, T2 equal to 457 Kelvin or 184 degree Celsius. Now, H2 enthalpy of the steam, H2 HG2 plus CP into T2 minus TST equal to 2751.38 plus 2.1 into 184 point minus 155.22. So H2 equal to 2811.82 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific volume at the throat section, V2 equal to VG2 into T2, that is temperature of the superheated steam divided by the saturation temperature. And necessarily, you have to substitute the temperature in Kelvin. So substituting, you will get 0.3734 meter cube per kilogram. Now, velocity at the throat section, V2 equal to square root of 2 into 1000 into H1 minus H2. Substituting H1 equal to 2943 and H2 equal to 2811.80 meters per second. Velocity is 512.2 meters per second. The mass flow rate through the nozzle, M equal to A2 V2 by small V2 equal to 0.5.2 kilograms per second. So, throat area equal to 1.35 10 power 4 meter square. And exit, the pressure is 232 bar. So, VG3 0.8854, HF3, HFG3 2201.6 kilojoules per kilogram, SF equal to 1.53 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG equal to 5.597 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, for isentropic flow, the entropy is constant, S1 equal to S3, the S3 equal to SF3 plus X3 into SFG3, substituting the value, calculating X3 equal to 0.964. Now, the enthalpy of the steam at the exit, H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3 equal to 504.7 plus 0.964 into 2201.3. So, that it leads to, that gives 2627 kilojoules per kilogram. And velocity at the, velocity, specific volume at the outlet X3 into VG3, 0.964 into 0.8854 equal to 0.8535. Now, the velocity, the exit V3 equal to square root of V2 square plus 2000 into H2 minus H3, substituting square root of 512.2 meter square plus 2000 into 2811.82 minus 2627, that is equal to 794.97 meters per second. And the area of the nozzle, area of the nozzle at the exit equal to A3 equal to M into small V3 divided by specific volume divided by velocity V3, 0.2 into 0.8535 divided by 794.97, that is equal to 2.14 10 power minus 4 meter square. The answers are throat area A2 equal to 1.35 centimeter square, exit velocity is 794.97 meters per second, and exit area equal to 214 centimeter square.